Hi everyone, welcome to Thorlabs. My name is Alex, and today I'll be showing you how to tune an adjustable isolator. In front of me, I have a 532 nanometer center wavelength narrowband adjustable isolator, and a 520 nanometer class 2 laser. While 520 nanometers is within the operating range of our isolator, I do still need to tune the elements within it to minimize transmission of back reflected light upstream going to the source, potentially destabilizing it or even causing damage. Now, one other thing of note is that I reduced the size of my beam solely because the beam coming out of this laser is a little bit too large for the clear aperture of this isolator. So I've used a two lens beam reducer here to shrink my beam diameter so it won't clip. I've also taken the time to pre-align all the components in my system here. Keeping them in line with a row of taps and at the same optical height, for which, since I have to pull my isolator in and out, I've used a locking collar to assure that my isolator will remain at the same position. I suggest you use one too, solely because it does make this alignment process easier. But moving forward, the first step for alignment would be inserting the isolator into the beam path and assuring that I'm not clipping my beam. And so I'm going to rotate this until I see maximum transmission, which you'll be seeing in the power meter I'm looking at in the bottom corner of your window. Locking it in place. Next, I need to align the body of the isolator within the slip ring mount. Isolators use polarization elements in their design, namely an input polarizer, which you want to align with your input state, whether it be a linear state or a slightly polarized state, such that you see maximum transmission in the forward direction. So I'm going to loosen this slip ring. I'm going to rotate the whole body of the isolator such that I see maximum transmission. It's approximately there. I'm going to lock the isolator into place. Next, I'll need to rotate the orientation of the isolator within my beam path. You'll notice on the side of the isolator, there's some arrows indicating the intended direction of light propagation. For this step, those arrows should actually be pointing towards your light source. And now I'll actually be aligning the polarizer closest to the laser source with this orientation. So I'll loosen the locking screw for this output polarizer, and I'm going to rotate it until I see minimum transmission in this direction, which is approximately there. I'm going to lock it in place. And now finally, I'm going to rotate the isolator back to its original orientation. And I'm going to align it for maximum transmission again. Lock it in place. And boom, my isolator's ready to use. I hope this helps you set up an isolator in your application, but if you have any questions, feel free to contact us here in tech support. Thank you.